Another question, what are the teachings of Buddhism? Do they believe in one God? That's what the question is. As far as Buddhism is concerned, if you read the teachings of Buddha, Buddha did not comment on God. Buddhism is an agnostic religion. Agnostic means neither does the person believe in God, neither does he deny God. The person who believes in God is called theist. Person who does not believe in God is called an atheist. But a person who's quiet, is silent on the existence of God, neither does he say there is God, neither does he say there is no God, he's called an agnostic. And Buddhism is an agnostic religion. And the scholars of Buddhism, they say that Buddha did not comment on God because when he came, polytheism was very much prevalent. And he thought that if he spoke about the oneness of Almighty God, people would not accept him. That is the reason he was silent. Neither did he say there was God, neither did he say there was no God. So he was quiet. But the scholars say that actually he believed in one God, but did not preach it because people would not agree with his teachings. This is the basis of Buddhism. And as far as the basic teachings are concerned, Buddha spoke about the four great truths. The first great truth was, there is sorrow and misery in this world. Second great truth, the cause of sorrow and misery is desire. Third great truth, sorrow and misery can be removed by removing desire. And the fourth great truth was, desire can be removed by following the eightfold path. And the eightfold path is, do not tell a lie, do not rob, many of which are same as the teachings of Islam. But if we analyze the four great truths of Buddha, the first one says, there is misery and sorrow in this world. There's no problem in accepting that. Point number two, the cause of sorrow and misery is desire. No problem with that. The third says that sorrow and misery can be removed by removing desire. Okay. And the last one says that desire can be removed by following the eightfold paths. Now if we follow all these four truths, if we analyze, the last two truths, they're contradicting. The third truth says that sorrow and misery can be removed by removing desire. And the fourth one says that desire can be removed by following the eightfold path. Now once we follow the third great truth, that sorrow and misery can be removed by removing desire. Now once we remove desire, the fourth great truth says that desire can be removed by following the eightfold paths. To follow the eightfold paths, you should have a desire. So the moment you have a desire to follow eightfold path, where is the question of removing desire? So it's contradicting. If you analyze it with logic, the third great truth says that sorrow and misery can be removed by removing desire. Okay, fine, we remove desire. Desire can be removed by following the eightfold paths. And to follow the eightfold paths, you should have a desire. So you have to have a desire to remove desire. It's contradicting. So therefore, if we analyze analytically, logically, these four great truths cannot stand on its own. But many of the teachings of Buddha match with Islam. What matches, we agree. Ta'ala vila kalmitin savayam baina bainakum. Come to common terms as we now send you. Buddha even prophesied the coming of the last and final messenger, the Maitri. And I've given a talk, Namah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, in the various world religious scriptures. And there I've described in detail about he saying that there's a Maitri to come. And the Maitri, what he mentions, refers to no one but the last and final messenger, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Hope that answers the question. Wa akhira da'wana alhamdulillah rabbil alamin.